നമസ്കാരം. യുവർ ഡോക്ടറിന്റെ ഇന്നത്തെ എപ്പിസോഡിലേക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും സ്വാഗതം. നമ്മളോടൊപ്പം ഇന്ന് ജോയിൻ ചെയ്യുന്നത് ഡോക്ടർ മുഹമ്മദ് അഷ്ഫാഖ് കൊഞ്ച്വാല. ഹീസ് ദ കൺസൾട്ടന്റ് സ്പോർട്സ് ആൻഡ് ഓർത്തോപെഡിക് സർജൻ ഫ്രം സൗദി ജർമ്മൻ ഹോസ്പിറ്റൽ ദുബായ്. വെൽക്കം ടു ദ ഷോ ഡോക്ടർ.
താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച്.
താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച് ഫോർ ബീയിങ് ഹിയർ. ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ,
മൈ പ്ലഷർ. ഐ എം വെരി ഗ്ലാഡ് ആൻഡ് ഹാപ്പി ദാറ്റ് ഐ എം ഹിയർ വിത്ത് യു ആൻഡ് പ്രൊമോട്ടിംഗ് ദ സൗദി ജർമ്മൻ ഹോസ്പിറ്റൽ വിച്ച് പ്രൊവൈഡിംഗ് ദ ബെഞ്ച് മാർക്ക് ഓഫ് മെഡിക്കൽ ട്രീറ്റ്മെന്റ് ഇൻ ദ യു എ.
It's our pleasure. So, doctor, ഇന്ന് സംസാരിക്കാൻ പോകുന്നത് സ്പോർട്സ് റിലേറ്റഡ് ഇഞ്ചുറീസിനെ കുറിച്ച് ആയിരിക്കും. ഹി ഈസ് സ്പെഷ്യലൈസ്ഡ് ഇൻ സ്പോർട്സ് സർജറീസ്, റൈറ്റ്? ഹൗ ഈസ് ഇറ്റ് ഡോക്ടർ? വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഇറ്റ്?
ഇറ്റ്സ് ഫൈൻ. മൈ വർക്ക് ഈസ് ഐ എം എ സ്പോർട്സ് സർജൻ. ഐ ലുക്ക് ആഫ്റ്റർ പ്രൊഫഷണൽ players and sport related injury, the injury which are associated while doing the games. Mm-hmm. For example, I look after cricket team.
Okay.
I'm the medical team doctor for the ICC and Pakistan cricket team. Uh-huh. I look after the different clubs, the football clubs and rugby clubs, and I also work as a team doctor for Formula 1 as well.
Oh, that's great. All right, appo endal nammude prekshakarkku endengilum okka samshayangal undengil thirchayayittu vilikkavundana related to sports. He is basically from India but born and brought up in London.
Yes.
Yeah. All right, appo nammal moving on to the topic. So sports related injuries, any kind of sports can result into injuries, right?
Yes. What we need to do for any sport, you have to follow the principle of sports.
Mm-hmm.
The principle of sport is that you have to do warm up, you have to do stretching, and then you play the sports, and then you do the cool down. If you don't follow the principle, mm-hmm. you are most likely to have an injury.
Okay.
And in this scenario, you make sure you have done adequate warm up before you start the game.
Okay, what is the use of doing a warm up before any workout or any sports?
See, it depend upon what you do. For mm-hmm. example, if you are a brisk walker or a runner, you start walking 5 to 10 minutes with a brisk walk, and when your body feel warm, mm. or in this part of the world you feel little bit sweat, then your body is ready. Then you start the running and slowly and gradually build up your stamina. Initially run for a kilometer and then continue for 4-5k and make up to marathon run up to 40k. You can do that.
Okay, what can be the issues if we are not doing warm ups before the sports?
See, if you don't do the warm up, there is a possibility the body metabolism is not ready, the uh-huh. muscles are not ready.
Okay.
And when they are not ready, there is most likely to have injury of the muscles. It depends upon the different grades of the ages of the patients or the sports person.
Mm-hmm.
For example, in young age, under the age of 20, 25, you are capable of doing any injury, you can do that. But when you reach up to the 40, you have to be careful. After the 40, you make sure that you have adequate warm-up, stretching, and your body is fit to play the sports.
Mm-hmm. All right. So what are the common injuries related to sports?
See, depend upon what sort of sports active. For example, okay. in football, mm-hmm. I look after football, different football team in UAE,
mm-hmm.
and the common sports injury is ligament injury and meniscal tear and kneecap dislocation,
uh-huh.
and which can be easily sought. Now,
okay.
one more thing, can I say something about this?
Definitely.
Whenever you have an injury, remember the word rice. You eat rice, remember the word rice. Rest, ice, compression, and elevation.
Oh.
This is the followed principle when you have an injury.
Okay, so could you please repeat it once again?
And I would say that you have to remember the word rice.
Mm-hmm.
The rice which we eat. Rest, R for rest,
mm-hmm.
I for ice, C for compression, E for elevation. If you have a knee injury, remember rest it, ice it, and put some knee support and see how things are. And similarly, you can do for the shoulder, elbow and other part of the body.
All right. So, what are the preparations before sports? Like, should we eat before this many hours and we should do a warm up? What are the preparations?
See, it depends upon if you are in this part of the world. If you are a professional, then you have to look after your diet.
Mm-hmm.
The diet is very important. In the diet, you have adequate protein, carbohydrates and fat,
mm-hmm.
and especially you require some vitamins and supplement that can help you out. In
uh-huh.
that scenario, in the diet, I always recommend for my ordinary patient, you must have one banana a day,
mm-hmm.
which provides selenium, magnesium and all the other nutrition, and then one apple a day which provide iron, and then if you have a a glass of milk, which provide calcium, vitamin D, and other supplements. So these three make you perfect. You don't need to take vitamins.
Oh, that's great. So what are the things we should avoid, as if we are really passionate about sports? What are the things we should avoid, like food?
For example, you can avoid, depend upon how good you are in looking after yourself, mm-hmm. and the disciplines in yourself. For example, you make sure that you don't eat the junk food.
Okay.
And you don't avoid eating just fatty food. Mm-hmm. However, if you are a fatty food lover or you have a sweet lover, mm-hmm. then you have to burn this thing out. Oh. See, the control of the body and fitness depend upon the two things. One mm-hmm. is the diet, mm-hmm. and the second is you have to depend upon the workout.
True.
This is very important.
Right. All right. So once we get an injury related to sports, what are the things we can do?
Once you get injury, as I said to you earlier, you have to remember the word rice. Mm-hmm. And once you are suspicious that you have a major injury, yeah. make sure you had been transported to an appropriate hospital or mm-hmm. emergency department, just like a Saudi German hospital, mm-hmm. and is to be treated by the relevant doctors. In the emergency department, the doctor do an appropriate history, clinical examination, and then he do appropriate test. And then if he think that, for example, is orthopedic ligament injury, they call the sports surgeon who look after it and take the matter further from there.
Okay, so what are the injuries related to football, and as you mentioned, ligament issues and the dislocation of knees, all this, right?
Yes.
So these all can result into some another issues.
See, if you have a meniscal injury. Meniscal is a cartilage between the two bone and a ligament which join the two bone together. If you have injury, if you have a young patient and you have not done, you have a symptom of instability, a knee giving away, a knee locking, and it will further deteriorate, which may lead to osteoarthritis, which is the damage of the articular cartilage. Mm-hmm. And once the articular cartilage is damaged, your mobility has been restricted.
Okay, what are the other common injuries related to other sports?
See, if you also look after the rugby teams, when I look after the rugby, they have a shoulder dislocation uh-huh. and shoulder injury, which can be easily sorted out, because most of the injury in the shoulder is pain, discomfort. This can be treated with conservative management, with physiotherapy, remember the rice, and then require a relevant investigation. And then being as a sports surgeon, I'm an arthroscopic surgeon. I do fix it up arthroscopically, and I'm very quick in fixing up. And if the patient or player have an injury, we can fix it up and they go back to the game within 4 to 6 months' time.
Within 4 to 6 months' time.
Back to
so them. All the injuries should undergo a surgery? Is it necessary?
No. See, it depends upon assessment of the patient. Normally, if the patient come to you and if he's a sedentary lifestyle, most of them, 90 to 95% of them manage conservatively with physiotherapy and pain management. Mm-hmm. However, if you are a professional player, then you need to go back to the game early. Then you require a quick fit solution. And surgery, most of the cases provide a quick fit solution, which can be fixed very easily.
All right. What are the mistakes sportsmen usually do, which results into injuries?
See, in this part of the world, there are few things which sportsmen have to be very careful about. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the football.
Okay.
In this part of the world, the sportsmen have to make sure that he do adequate warm-up and make sure he's fit to play the game. Mm-hmm. He does not play the game to make himself fit. Mm. This is a very important point. And then he have adequate nutritional diet. Mm. Now, a 45-year-old, 50-year-old gentleman, a 40-year-old gentleman cannot supposed to play the game with a 15-year-old or 20-year-old person mm-hmm. because he's most likely going to do that because they are faster, and at the same time when the game is going on, the adrenaline is secreting, and then he have most likely to have injury.
True.
Plus, you have to make sure that when you play the games, the players, other players knows the rule of the game. It's very important. Mm-hmm. It's very important.
So these are the common things sportsmen should take care of,
exactly,
right?
Yeah.
And is there any limitations, like a sportsman should work this much hours, or he should work out this many hours only? Is there something, restrictions like that, some limit?
See, let's talk about from a normal patient, because our audience is mostly of the normal people.
True.
In my opinion, what adequately sports activity for a normal person is you require a brisk walk for at least 30 minutes. Okay, and if he is capable of taking stairs, that make him his cardio, just ordinary thing. Okay, avoid using cars, just try to walk 5 to 10 minutes brisk walk every day. This will really help you out. And make sure he take an adequate diet also. Avoid doing junk food, he makes slip. It make him slim. And the other thing is that he do a little bit exercise 5 to 10 minutes at home. In our community, especially this community which we are producing, they are very capable of doing a yoga. They're very fond of. And if they do the yoga appropriately, only 10 minutes a day, that's making perfectly.
That's great. All right. And coming back to like cricket. All right, usually people every time get a hit by a ball, which is really hard, right?
Yes.
So what is the major, what is the treatment for that?
See, depend upon what sort of injury you have. For example, I had a patient just 2 weeks ago, a ball hit directly to his knee. He have a fracture knee. He have a fracture of the kneecap, and then a ligament injury, which he underwent surgery at Saudi German Hospital, and the patient did extremely well, and he's walking at the moment. But he was a semi-professional cricketer, and if he's a semi-professional cricketer, I told him it will take approximately 4 to 6 months to go back to the game. However, if he is a professional cricketer, then it takes 6 to 9 months, because we have to train him, we have to make sure that he have adequate training before he get into the game. And then, as you say, if you play internationally, if you're playing for a particular country, then getting into the main team is slightly difficult, but if you work hard, you get it. As you have a lot of Indian teams which have been injured, players have been injured, and they're back in the team.
How important is meditating for sportsmen?
See, first of all, if you see looking after yourself and everything, meditation control your body. If the meditation control, if you are good enough, you take about all the pressure which you have, and it controls all the hormonals which secretion which is going on during the sports. And then if you have a good meditation, you will really control your everything what you're doing.
All right, coming back to Formula One, I'm pretty interested in that field. So what are the common injuries related to Formula One?
Formula One common injuries is a very complex injury. It's not like a body injury. It's a very compact injury. It's a psychological trauma, and we have to make sure the safety is very important. And the most injuries which they have are fractures, head and neck injury, or concussion, for which they require appropriate investigation.
Okay. So, so after that, after proper investigation, we can suggest them, right?
Exactly.
What are the proper treatments and all? If you face with a complex injury or something, then you can treat in Saudi German Hospital itself, right?
Yeah, Saudi German Hospital have provide a very good facilities. I think Mr. Bataji and Dr. Reem have provide a benchmark of the medical treatment in this part of the world, and we are capable of treating not the sports related. In fact, they're covering all the aspect of sport. For example, you have a cardiac problem, abdominal problem, or any associated. And we have a very good rehabilitation center, which is the ideal rehabilitation center in this part of the world. We have a very good swimming pool, a very up to mark international physiotherapist, which can help us to provide.
Is it less likely to have common, diseases like cholesterol and sugar, all these in sportsmen, or is it can be common?
This can be problem. The most common problem which we come across in a sportsman, if a patient is diabetic, it's a sports
diabetic.
Player. If he is diabetic, I think most of the player, a cricket player or the footballers, they are diabetic.
Why is it?
If they are diabetic, the diabetic is not from their naturally, it may be due to hereditary, which they have from the family. Once they have it, we have to make sure the sugar level is controlled during the games, during the training session and after it. Because there are players who may collapse after the game or during the game, so we have to make sure that sugar control is very important. Regarding the cholesterol in a sedentary lifestyle people here, they make sure the cholesterol is well controlled. I think rice, which is very common in our food, and this chapati mm-hmm. with a lot of oil. Just try to avoid that.
Try to avoid that. So what are the things a sportsman should check before entering to the playground?
See, as I said to you earlier, this whatever sports you want to play, you want to make sure that you're fit to play the sports mm-hmm. rather than sports making you fit to play the game. Mm-hmm. Okay, and make sure that you have done adequate training and adequate what we say is understanding of the sports. Mm-hmm. And nowadays coaches are available, the managements are available, they can help you out. However, if you're playing outside with your colleague in this part of the world, you go to gym, train yourself. And the reason which we do, why we, what make us to say that we are doing good, if you go to every gym, there's a mirror there in mm-hmm. front of you. Mm-hmm. The mirror will tell you exactly how what you're doing. Or if you are not sure what you're doing, ask your colleague or your friend to make a video clips of your gym activity. Oh. So you know what mistakes you're doing.
Okay, all right. Doctor, we have a caller with us. Hello.
Hello. Can I talk to the doctor?
Yes, sure, please.
My name is Abraham from Dubai.
Abraham, yes.
Good evening, doctor.
Good evening.
Yeah, the major thing I want to discuss with you is the tennis elbow.
A tennis elbow.
So when it is became more familiar when Sachin hits that thing that the whole world knows that was such a harmful thing, even if your career will be stopped out. Is it having more harder than what we think when a cricketer like me, if I have a tennis elbow should be happened if we ended my career?
I give a very good example. The tennis elbow is not a big issue for us to tackle it. Okay, the first of all, yes. Most of the time you need a conservative management with good physiotherapy and see how things are. The second step, what we do, we give a shot of cortisone injection, and sometimes nowadays we're going stem cells and a PRP injection, which is a regenerative okay. medicine. And the third option, what I do, is a surgery in which I do arthroscopically, elbow camera surgery, and put the camera in and release it. It takes only 15 to 20 minutes to do the surgery. I give you an example, a very good cricketer of Indian cricket team, Tendulkar. Nowadays, if he, this problem which we have, instead of saying a tennis elbow, we say Tendulkar elbow. So it can be easily treated. It's not, but you need to go to an appropriate person who is capable of handling it and to make sure you're fine. I think it's very easy treatable. It's not a hard one to do so.
After one tennis elbow came, how long time to get back to the ground?
If I see a professional cricketer, as I see, I'm the part of the ICC also. And if you depend upon if you are a batsman, in 4 to 6 weeks' time, if you are a right-hand fast bowler on the right-hand side, then approximately 8 to 12 weeks, because I do arthroscopically. I don't open up. If you do arthroscopically, there is no hardly scar. You need a good rehabilitation, 6 to 8 weeks. But if you are a professional wrestler and a fighter, it takes 3 months onwards.
Okay, that means after the surgery, on the back to the ground, you should need complete rest to be when you're back to the ground.
No. What we do, after 3-4 days' time, what we do, we start physiotherapy, rehabilitation, and once the rehabilitation done, depend upon the things you are. If you are my batsman, I will allow you to go back to the training program in 4 weeks' time. And if you are my professional batsman, you can play the game in 6 to 8 weeks' time or 12 weeks' time. However, if you are my bowler, it will take a little bit time.
Okay, thank you, doctor.
Hope it's clear, Mr. Abraham. Thank you so much.
Yes,
bye-bye.
Yes,
doctor, shin splints is a common word related to sports, right? What is it, actually?
A shin splint is a condition in which there are different compartments in the lower leg which is become tight. It's very common with people who play football, rugby, and contact sports, and a marathon runner. Mm-hmm. In this, the muscle get tighter in the compartment.
Okay.
And it can be easily dealt with easily with conservative management in the form of physiotherapy, mm-hmm. in the form of shin splint, which footballer wear. And the worst scenario is that you can do a small surgery to rule it out, to heal it out. But unfortunately, it's not required, and it's good.
Oh, all right. And how about the ankle sprain? Usually, we don't understand if whether it's a sprain or not. How to understand if we got a sprain?
Few things we have to notice that. First of all, the mechanism of injury when twisting of the ankle happens, you understand if you hear any crack, if you hear any pop, it means there is possibility of fracture.
Uh-huh.
It's better to come to the hospital, for example, Saudi German emergency department, do the x-ray and see how things are.
Uh-huh.
And then once the x-ray is ruled out, I think you need to go to the sports surgeon, and most of the ankle injury can be treated conservatively with, as I said to you, rest, ice, compression, elevation, and then a good physiotherapy.
All right. അപ്പോൾ എന്തായാലും നമ്മുടെ സമയം ദാ ഇവിടെ അവസാനിക്കുകയാണ് ഡോക്ടർ. അൺഫോർച്ചുനേറ്റ്ലി ആ ടൈം ഇസ് എൻഡിങ് ഹിയർ ബിക്കോസ് ഐ ഗസ് വി ഹാവ് എ ലോട്ട് മോർ ടു ടോക്ക് ഓൺ ദ സെയിം ടോപ്പിക്
ബട്ട്
മേ ബി സം അതർ ടൈം.
Yes, sure.
അപ്പോൾ നമ്മുടെ പ്രേക്ഷകർക്ക് ഇന്നത്തെ ഒരു സെഷൻ വളരെ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് ആയിരുന്നു, വളരെ ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റിംഗ് ആയിരുന്നു, ഇൻഫോർമേറ്റീവ് ആയിരുന്നു എന്ന് വിശ്വസിക്കുകയാണ്. താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച് ഡോക്ടർ വൺസ് അഗെയിൻ ഫോർ യുവർ ടൈം. ഇറ്റ് വാസ് വെരി ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റിംഗ് ആൻഡ് ഇൻഫോർമേറ്റീവ്.
താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച്.
നമ്മളിപ്പോൾ ഇവിടുന്ന് പോവാണ് മറ്റു എപ്പിസോഡുമായി. വീണ്ടും കാണുന്നത് വരെ ദിസ് ഇസ് നിഷ സൈനിങ് ഓഫ് ഫ്രം യുവർ ഡോക്ടർ ഫ്രം എൻടിവി യുഎസ് നമ്പർ വൺ ഇന്ത്യൻ ടെലിവിഷൻ ചാനൽ. ബൈ ആൻഡ് ടേക്ക് കെയർ.
ബൈ ബൈ. താങ്ക് യു.
ജനങ്ങൾക്കൊപ്പം, വാർത്തയ്ക്കൊപ്പം, നന്മയോടൊപ്പം.
എൻടിവി യുഎഇ to the world.